बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अल्लाहुम्मा सल्लि अला मोहम्मद व आलि मोहम्मद। वेलकम व्यूअर्स टू द लास्ट सेशन ऑफ नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट। एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो दैट नाउ वी हैव कम टू द एंड ऑफ दिस नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट लेक्चर सीरीज। सो टुडे इज माय लास्ट वीडियो ऑन द सेशन ऑफ नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आइडेंटिफाइड एंड रिव्यूड नॉलेज प्रैक्टिस ड्राइवर्स। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल आइडेंटिफाई एंड एक्सप्लोर सम पोटेंशियल नॉलेज मैनेजमेंट चैलेंजेस। So let's start the video and keep on watching this video till the end as you will come to know about the subject of new series. Identifying and confronting potential knowledge management challenges. There are many issues relating to culture, leadership and practice which can affect knowledge management. This session highlights just a few of many potential barriers. Challenges experienced in business moving towards a knowledge management focus. The nature of knowledge management necessitates major shifts in business principles, practices, and most importantly, values. Knowledge management is a complex business process. This session reviews some of the potential dilemmas and suggests some ways their potential impacts might be reduced. There are some main challenges in front of knowledge management. Challenge 1. Don't call it knowledge management. The early years of knowledge management were often littered with failed projects and initiatives. This has left a bitter taste in the mouth of many. Does the name matter? In some organizations, it is most unwise to use the term knowledge management. Instead, the various good practices might need to be linked to other organizational processes. After all, knowledge management should be seen as basic good business practice rather than a new and ambitious but largely unrealistic venture. Challenge 2. No time to think. The best of organizations can find that an excellent scheme fails in practice because people have no time to get involved despite their good intentions. Systems will work only if people use them. Knowledge can be exploited only if it is shared. The issue of time and capacity to share is an important challenge for firms. Firms which experience this problem need to encourage staff to take that time. Leaders need to let their staff know that they are expected to take the time to think about their actions. Challenge 3. New leaders, new agendas. The entry of new executive members into an organization can fill heart with fear. Will they support the knowledge strategy? Will they understand its purpose? Are they knowledge management advocates? How can they be educated and become involved with the knowledge agendas so that it does not lose its power during the translation process? Leaders new to an organization will not necessarily know what has been happening before they arrived. An initiating briefing document summarizing the background, current status, and expected future directions and issues provides an excellent starting point. However, most important is that new leaders take ownership of the knowledge strategy. In danger is that the existing group will regard the new leader as an interpoler rather than a leader and a partner. If this occurs, the agenda will become very vulnerable. Cutting the losses. Sometimes a knowledge management process will not deliver the expected or desired outcomes, as many results in considerable frustration in the knowledge community. This creates a dilemma for organization. Should it be continued or abandoned? Which will result in the greatest fallout of goodwill, keeping the process or stopping? Is the process salvageable if additional resources or efforts are invested? Why has it failed? What could be learned from the process? It is important to communicate with the knowledge community so that they are also part of the process. Forums for ongoing discussions would be a help. Long-term value can be gained by undertaking failure analysis to identify what went wrong and how it can be avoided the next time. Improved evaluation should be considered. Challenge 5. Been there, done there. Another risk for knowledge management is when people feel they have already given knowledge management a trial and it failed. Disenchanted participants are a major challenge when new knowledge management developments are to be introduced. It is important to avoid repeatedly introducing roles in re-engineering. The knowledge community and incentives through human resource practices will be important. If a failure analysis was undertaken, a public review of why they failed and how the problems have been solved in this new version will reassure disillusioned employees. Challenge 6. System versus people and process. Focusing on the creation of an effective knowledge system can be persuasive when developing a knowledge management strategy. Systems are visible, tangible things which people understand. Money can be spent and results seen in a relatively short space of time. On the other hand, an organizational culture is much harder to view, measure, and manage. It takes longer to create and is more vulnerable to new pressures and challenges. As many failed ventures have discovered, knowledge relies on people first and systems second. The people who use the system need similar careful management. Funds spent on encouraging awareness, familiarity, and adoption of the philosophy and processes can be far more useful to the organization than a sophisticated system which is unused. Challenge 7. Managerialism versus inspiration and innovation. Knowledge management relies on a delicate balance between efficiency and responsiveness. An inherent danger in building knowledge management systems is that they become highly regulated and managerial in focus. This increases the risk of mechanical activities, which lack the inspiration, commitment, and innovation on which knowledge management relies. Challenge 8. Under pressure. When organizations are pressed for funds or face increased competition from external sources, they tend to revert to defensive behavior. In this setting, the contribution to a long-term knowledge strategy may lose impetus. Once again, leadership is essential. Leaders need to see both long-term and short-term priorities, and dedicated knowledge service also provides ongoing support through both difficult and good times. Challenge 9. Resistance to change. Most organizations have staffs who want to maintain the status quo, resisting the push towards applying different techniques and processes. Support, leadership, and some performance management can help move staff towards preliminary exploration. Mentorship, teamwork, and models of change processes which have worked can also help influence resistant staff to accept new processes. Last but not the least, challenge number 10, you have had your share. Funding for knowledge management is extremely important. The documentation and monitoring of knowledge outcomes and effect is very important. Planning for knowledge management integration needs to assure the funding sources, which will ensure good outcomes for the organization. Knowledge management can be very vulnerable to threats of this nature when these challenges and issues are analyzed. So, knowledge practices need to be well regulated and accountable for the best of available resourcing. The influence of culture and leadership also need to work hand in hand to generate trust, which can limit the impact of the many challenges and issues explored in this session. Viewers, these were the main 10 challenges that might be occurred during knowledge management practices. So, let's quickly discuss some key knowledge management principles. It is useful to focus on a few key principles which draw these many threads together. Principle number 1. Knowledge management is everyone's business. This is not an executive or managerial issue. A successful knowledge environment consistently indicates knowledge management works when all members of the organization are both custodian and advocates. Second principle, knowledge practices are legitimate core business. Knowledge management is not something one does if there is time at the end of the day. It should be regarded as essential business that must be done before others. Third principle is communication is essential. No matter what level or role a person has, a knowledge and awareness of knowledge strategy must be maintained. This relies on effective communication. Principle number 4. High performance should be encouraged. Sharing of learning and lessons, recognition of those who can act as model, and ongoing socialization of staff in a learning framework are all important ways of generating a strong learning focus. Knowledge cultures operate from recognition of the contribution staff bring to the knowledge process and encouragement of further improvement. Okay, viewers, let's together conclude the knowledge management series. As the nature and complexity of work changes, organizations will need to be more fully attuned to the knowledge that is held and where it can be shared. An aging workforce poses a significant threat to the future knowledge retention if we do not build effective management into basic business practice. Knowledge management relies on systems, cultures, practices, and leadership in the knowledge community. The link of knowledge management to collaboration, communication, innovation, creativity, and learning needs to be recognized and actively pursued. Leadership plays an important part in creating an environment which stimulates these factors. However, viewers, there is still much that needs to be learned about knowledge management and how it can be nurtured and effectively stimulated. It is clear that knowledge management relies on four broad principles. Every person needs to be knowledge advocates. Knowledge management should be a part of basic roles people take on. Communication is essential, and high-quality performance should be encouraged. I am thankful to you for your support and encouragement. And now I'm switching to the new series of new topic, and the topic of our new knowledge journey is entrepreneurship. Yes, viewers, our next session is all about entrepreneurship. Hopefully together we all have good learning and knowledge sharing in next videos as well. And also I would say that your valuable suggestions regarding previous topics and upcoming topic of discussions are highly appreciated. You can subscribe my channel and like and share my videos and give your contribution for sharing this light of knowledge to more and more people around you, because sharing is caring and it ultimately returns goodness to us. And how can I forget to share the quote of the session in this video? That quote is also about sharing. As Hazrat Ali al-Aslam said, the little that you give in the way of God will bring great returns to you. With these beautiful and golden words, I am signing off from the knowledge management series. Always stay blessed and lots of thanks.